What's their skill level? Is it an age kind of a thing? Is it an economic kind of a thing? Is it a skill or an industry specific kind of a thing? Okay, also when you're designing your speech, the room, the venue, is it big, small? Are they gonna have bad acoustics or bad lighting? Like we had to just turn off the lights just now with William helping me here. Also, is there gonna be an audio system? Are you gonna have a microphone or do you have to use your big boy voice? Screens and monitors. If you use any sort of hand gestures or props, are they gonna be able to see it? You're way up on a huge stage, way, way far away, and if you have props, they're not even gonna be able to see you using them. Or is there a camera on you and you have a big 20-foot screen behind you showing you what you're doing? Also, the time of day. If you can work it at all, always try to be the second session after lunch. The second session after lunch is the worst. You don't wanna be that one. You wanna be the first one in the morning or the first one after lunch. You definitely do not want to be the second one after lunch. Okay, preparation, faster, funnier. You want to make sure you engage your audience, you want to keep them awake, you want to keep them happy and interested. Also, you want to do your preparation for your presentation at least a few days in advance, preferably a week in advance, to get a chance to practice it. You want to even maybe videotape it, and you want to get a chance to work out all the bugs and all the kinks, and have someone critique you so that you get even better before you even go on stage for the first time. Okay, and videotape it if you can, which is always good, so you can kind of watch like those football films that they always do. Okay, handouts. Sometimes having blank spaces on the handouts is really good because then the audience stays more engaged. They get a chance to fill in some of the blanks while they're listening. And that helps them retain more information as well. Also, a backup medium, if you have an electronic presentation like this here with the PowerPoint, what if the power goes out? What if the light bulb goes out? So you want to have some sort of backup. Now I've made a handout for people to look at here to follow along if you'd like, but that could be my only source of information if the light bulb burns out or if there's no power in the outlet tonight. Also, you want to make allies with the tech staff so that they can help you, give you some clues before you get there what you'll need to do. Are they going to have lightsabers or light pointers for you? Are you going to have to bring your own? This is a dollar at the dollar store. Also, visit the venue beforehand so you can see what's going on and get a feel for how big the room is, if you have to look in certain locations to see the audience, if you're going to be behind a pillar, all that kind of stuff. Okay, physical preparation. The night before, get a good night's sleep. You don't want to have any bags under your eyes and you want to be able to concentrate. A light meal, several hours beforehand, not right beforehand, but several hours beforehand. And then not too much caffeine like I had today. Make extra time for everything. I got here at 5:30 tonight, just to make sure that everything can be worked out properly. And lists for everything, what to do and what to pack. Slide this. Okay, execution, arrive early, like I mentioned. It's never too early to get here early. Have help, ask for people to help you with things like turning off the light, passing out the handouts, helping you bring in your luggage and your stuff from the car. But do a pre-walk-on. Make sure you have water pre-positioned for you and any sort of mics or wiring that you might need. Okay, after actions, it's always good to have a grip and grin with the audience. They can exchange business cards, maybe take some photos, maybe have some book sales or CD sales. Send out a survey the next day. Find out what people liked about it, what they didn't like about it, maybe what you can do better next time, what you can do a different topic next time. Also, phone and email follow-ups. Give you a chance to sell, possibly, and get new customers onto your database and find out more about what your customers currently like, and you can get them for repeat customers. Okay, here's a quick breakdown of the effort. Very, very, very early, just a little bit of thinking about what's going on in your design phase, in your preparation phase, and you create your presentation, then the event, walking in and seeing the scoping of the room, executing it about 15 to 20% of the whole thing, and then post-event here, and follow-up also just a little tiny bit. Okay, so the 80-20 rule, 80% preparation, 20% perspiration, and it'll be a great, great event. You'll have a lot of fun, you'll make a lot of money, live that opulent lifestyle, and if you're having fun, then your audience will have fun too. Okay, sadly, no time for questions. But thank you for your attention, I really appreciate it. Have a great rest of your day.